Hey guys, long time no vlog. I'm sorry about that. I've just been trying to cope with the heat waves in the UK, and it's finally raining and grey outside. Also went on holiday to Switzerland with my boyfriend's family for a wedding, his second cousin's wedding, which was insane, in a castle in Aigle. So I thought I would sit down with you this morning and just chat and catch up, and then we can get on to some sewing and some bits that I've been up to. I'm gonna start doing my makeup while we chat so that I can be nice and productive today. I've just been using concealer on my face. I haven't put makeup on in a while. I did yesterday for a beauty pie job, but it's just been too hot to wear makeup, so I have not been wearing any at all. And I find in the summer I can get away with just wearing a little bit of concealer. I've got a really annoying smudge on this contact lens and it's really ticking me off. But I can't be bothered to replace it. It's so annoying when you get a smudge on your contact lens, especially if you're out and about and you can't do anything about it. If I'm going out for the day, I'll put my contacts in after doing makeup, just in case like the brush touches my contact lens or something. Anyway, that's not interesting. The last sewing project I did were the quilted cushions, and those are still up on my website if any of you are interested in them. I've just put way too much of this on my face. I'll put some down here. I put those up, and then I fell into a bit of a dark hole again. And I haven't really been feeling myself that recently, and with the hot weather I just can't work and focus or do anything. I'd try and do stuff and then it would just go horribly wrong, so I sort of just gave up doing things during the heat wave. But now I'm on to my next project, where I'm making some toiletry makeup bags. I've got three different sizes that I'm making, so hopefully those will be a good seller. They are also quite fun to make, and I found really nice high quality fabrics, and the lining should be arriving today, and the zips are really good quality. I didn't want to scrimp on quality of these bags because I really love a good high quality makeup bag. Just went and changed my contact lens because it was annoying me too much. So now I can see properly. I'm going to fill in my eyebrows. So yes, life recently has been a little bit tough for me because I've sort of been in a space of not knowing what I want to do. And I mean, I love sewing and doing all of that, but I'm like, how long am I going to be able to do that for the rest of my life? Basically just been freaking out a bit about the future. So I'm considering putting a little portfolio together and seeing if I can get like a little part-time job in fashion somewhere. Not sure where or what I would do. That's what I'm thinking at the moment. And obviously the cost of living in the UK is rising. Everything is just getting very expensive, so I'm just trying to think of more ways I can have a bit more of a steady income. Which I'm sure a lot of you guys are in the same sort of boat at the moment. Just want to be a bit more financially secure. Saying that, I did put myself on for another ceramics course, but I thought I really enjoy that and it will be money well spent. And I also ordered some clay to start making some things before I start, because I've done two sessions before now. And so I have a little idea of what I'm doing, and I'm going to do some hand building. Flory is also spending a few nights at my parents' house so I can get some work done. Not that she's a big distraction, but it's just nice to be able to wake up and get straight on with work rather than walking her and everything. And I think my parents actually really miss having Flory around, so it's quite nice that she can just go back there every now and then. Makeup is done for the day, so now let's head over to my little studio. So this is what I'm working on at the moment, our little quilted bags. So they come in three different sizes, and I'm doing them in three different prints or colours at the moment. I'm going to spend all day today trying to get through most of this quilting. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get through all of it today or not. I started last night quilting the little things, and then I've got to stitch all of the labels on, and then I've got to cut out the lining when it arrives, but it hasn't arrived yet. So this big roll over here is what I've been using as the wadding, and it's basically this fusible wadding. Apparently you can get it double-sided, but I only needed it single-sided fused, so I stick that onto the fabric, and then I don't have to do any sort of tacking before I quilt, and it's just such a lifesaver. I forgot to mention the foot I bought to do this quilting with, and it's honestly a lifesaver. So it's basically just a normal foot, but with a guide that you can move along to however long you want to make the quilting. So I've got it on 2 centimeters at the moment. I don't know if you can see the little guide, which is just here, and I just line it up with the last row of stitching I did. And then that's it, you've got really nice parallel lines. So I'm literally just stitching lines all day. Now the next day, and I finished all of the quilting yesterday, so everything is ready to go into the next stage, and that is sewing on all of the little labels. So I designed a slightly different label than my usual ones, and this is made in a nice cotton, and I'm just going to stitch those in the middle on the front. And then for the method of stitching these on, I leave a nice long thread at both ends, and then I thread through the thread and tie it at the back so that it stays in place and doesn't unravel. So I'm going to work on the small ones first, I think. I've got a centre notch, and then I measure a certain amount down, and that is where the label sits. Okay, so for the smaller bags, I have to measure 4 centimetres down from the centre front. And then I just place my label in the middle and stitch it down. And I make sure I have a good amount of length on each side to be able to thread it back through. So that's stitched on, and then I just go and grab a hand sewing needle. And then I just thread the outer thread, or the top thread, through the needle, and then back round towards the back. And then I'll tie that in a knot at the back. And that is how I stitch on my little label. So now I've got to go and do this to the rest of them. A little while since I last updated you guys. I actually had sort of a week away from a camera But I was still doing lots of sewing, so I've got some clips I can put in here of all of the sewing I got done this week. All of the little bags yesterday, so we've got those there and done, and I sewed all of the zips into the next size. How satisfying is that? So those are ready to be sewn together today, and then I need to do the zips on the last size and sew those together. That is all the sewing I've got done recently, and I've finished all the bags now, and now I need to start taking photos of them and putting them up on my website and all of that fun stuff. Let's head into my studio and I can show you all of the different sizes of the bags that we've got. The lighting in my studio is rubbish in the mornings, so I've just had to make do with a little bit of fluorescent light, a little bit of daylight and mishmash of everything, so I'm sorry if it's a bit weird, but I wanted to show you everything I've been working on. You'll have seen from the previous clip all of the little bags laid out on the table, and I stuffed them all full of tissue paper ready to be sent out. So this is the little boxy wash bag, and I am obsessed with this shape. I love it so much. I love how it turned out. I've got little tabs at the end and a little tie on the zip. And I can't remember if I mentioned earlier in the video that I picked up YKK zips because I wanted a zip that was definitely gonna withstand a lot of use, so you can use them for a long, long time. And it's a really, really nice quality zip in this sort of antique brass finish. So that is the first one. And all of these shapes come in three different patterns. I've got this beautiful white floral one, and then I've got this multicoloured floral, which looks like that. It's really lovely and muted in real life. Sometimes it can come across a bit colourful on the camera, but it's not colourful in real life. Well, it's colourful, but like a really nice muted. The yellows in real life are really mustardy and nice and desaturated. So, love this print. And then the final fabric I used is this really gorgeous dusty pink linen. And obviously they're all quilted and they've all got my little cotton label at the front. So those are the boxy wash bags. And then I have these slightly taller ones in the three different colorways again. And this one, as I just said, is a lot taller and it's still got a huge capacity for it. I feel like this one is a good shape if you don't want it as a wash bag and you want to use it maybe something else, then it's quite a good one for that. You could use it for toiletries, you can just use it to store things in, you could use it for a giant pencil case. Fits a lot in here, so you can really go wild. And then this is it in the other two colours. And then finally I made some little pouches. These are also quilted and have the little label on the front. So we've got the white floral, then the nice pink linen, and then finally the multicolored floral, and they're all lined really nicely inside. I love to have little bags like this that I chuck in a tote bag that I can put like my phone, plasters, tissues, anything that just would get lost in a big tote bag. These are perfect for that. But they'd also fit inside the wash bag if you wanted to put brushes in it or something smaller. So yeah, I'm very happy with how those bags have turned out, and I will leave my website links down below if you want to check them out. I also have a few quilted cushion covers left on my website if you wanted to check those out too. Yeah, I hope you guys like them. I really wanted to create something that was at a reasonable price point for everyone and just something that I like to use a lot. Yeah, hopefully I've managed to create some bags that you guys will really like and love using. And they're completely washable as well, so can just chuck them into the washing machine. I'd probably turn them inside out and then wash them if you are going to wash them. Thought I would show you some secondhand bits I picked up recently to end this video, because I went to a charity shop recently and I posted it on my Instagram stories and I promised that I would share what I got, so I'm gonna do that now. First thing is this pair of curtains, which my mum actually spotted, so very good, Louise, well spotted, in the charity shop when I went with her the other day. And they are a pair of old John Lewis curtains. I think I'm going to use the fabric and not use them as curtains because I don't really have any rooms, or don't think I'd plan any rooms that would have blue and red and green. So I thought I could use this as like a festive fabric, or just make some really cute little ruffled cushion covers with this. So yeah, I don't know if you can, there's a little close up of the fabric. Then when I went home recently, I popped into the old flight house and I found two cute prints. The first one is this one, and I don't know what it is about prints and me. I think as soon as I see it, I know if I love it or hate it, and when I know that I love it, which is very rarely, then I will pick it up. And I think I have a thing for palm trees in prints because I have a H&M print out there that's got some palm trees in it. But I just love this print so much, and I loved the sort of gold frame it's in. It's sort of white and gold and black, and it's just very simple. So I think that's what I loved about it. Goes really nicely with the curtains in here. So very happy about that, and now I kind of wish I had more of this print or like a similar version of it. So that goes up on the wall behind the camera. I'll take you to the bedroom to show you the next print because it's on my bedside table. And then here is a little print that I have on my bedside. I really love these ones that have just a print of somewhere on them. This one is of Pembroke Castle. We kind of went to that sort of area a lot growing up for holidays. So quite nice that I actually do know the area, and I just fell in love with the border and this gorgeous greeny bluey colour with the gold and the slightly faded paper and everything. I just love it, and also the frame is really cute as well. And they're never too expensive. I think this one was £12, which for a frame and a print is a very good deal, I think. I also picked up this enamel bin from Facebook Marketplace recently for £10. So I was very chuffed with myself for getting that, and also the guy I picked it up from was a really cute old man, and he had a farm and there were loads of little animals everywhere. That was just, I think I might have a few more things downstairs, so let's go and have a look. I'm in my kitchen now, and I do have a few more things to show you. This one is a little reel of yarn that I found in a charity shop, and I actually really like these as just as decoration on the side. And then I picked up these lovely light wooden lamp bases. I've got two of these, but I've just got one out for now. And I now need to find the lampshades to go on top of them, but I thought I'd sort of just keep them in storage for now until I move somewhere where I've got a spare room and I can put them either side, and they'll look very, very cute. I just love the curves and the bumpiness. It's also nice that I found a pair of them because it's quite hard to find a pair of lamp bases. And then I picked up some plates. Well, these are more like bowls really, I guess. And I just really liked the black and whiteness of these. And I don't know, the black and white and the sort of beigey cream and the little landscapes they've got going on. I think they're all a little bit different as well, which I really liked. And these are this brand, if you want to look it up on eBay. I picked these up in Bicester in the giant warehouse charity shop. And they actually have more of these if you're interested, so they'll probably still have them. Recently in the charity shops, I've been searching for this really sweet little white with nice little details. So like little fruit and shapes around the rim, like quite bumpy. I'm really not good. I swear every time I turn the camera on, my words just get mumbled and jumbled up and I just cannot talk. So sorry about that, you have to just put up with it. But I got this really sweet gravy boat and it's just such a good size and shape. My boyfriend makes a really good gravy with a roast. So now we've got the perfect serving dish for it. And then in another charity shop I found the matching little sugar jar. So I've now got that. I don't love the angles on the handles. But it is quite cute. And then I managed to find two cups and saucer sets. So I've got the really cute little plate, and these were £1 for the set. So I thought even if I don't use them as they are, which I think they're quite cute as they are, then I can definitely use the plate for putting plants on for drainage. So yes, very happy with those purchases. I did pick up a really nice side table, coffee table sort of thing for £10 as well, but that was about a month ago, and it's a bit hard to show you right now because it's a bit of a mess. I guess I could show you. There is a reason why it was £10, because it's a bit wobbly and very distressed looking, but that's kind of what I like. I actually saw this table underneath like two tables and I just was like, I need that table in my life, and I was like, I don't care how much it is. And then he was like, oh, £10, and I was like, yeah. So it actually folds up at both sides and you can obviously have it up like that, but we just have it at the side at the moment. We just put drinks on it, and sometimes if we're gonna eat in front of the TV, we pull it round to the front. But yeah, how lovely is that for £10? I was very chuffed with that purchase. So I'm gonna carry on looking out for little side tables like this at charity shops. And I'm also going to look out for a tiny little bookcase that could go over there, because I want to put a lamp on something else, because I can't put a lamp on it here because the plug socket's over there and I'd have to, it just wouldn't work. And then the top that I'm wearing is also new from H&M, so I will leave it linked down below. It's very comfy. It's got these really cool flared sleeves. Yeah, I think that's everything I've picked up recently from the charity shops and vintage shops. I will finish the video here because I don't think there's much else to show you right now. And I've got a parcel coming soon with some exciting clothing that I can hopefully put into a haul video for you guys. I might actually do a clay video next, because I bought a load of clay to have a play with. And so I might do a video on that, and we'll see how that turns out. I hope you're all having a wonderful day, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.